Well, here I am again. Morris Lupton, off for my morning walk. This must be the finest stretch of beach on the finest island the whole world over. For a little speck of land in the North Atlantic, it sure is a good un. Ah, but this walk isn't the same without Sparky. She did love chasing that tennis ball. Oh, Sparky, I miss you, girl. Shelmerston used to be a quiet place. You'd only come here if you like fishing or bird watching. But since the new ferry service started, we get loads of tourists. Ah, but what you gonna do? It's always changing. Oh, I see those yoga folks up at the lighthouse are up bright and early, saluting the sun and all that. I always thought that looked like fun. The crater's definitely been smoking more than usual lately. That's funny, that, for a dormant volcano. Yep, Shelmerston's a smashing place. I'm lucky to call it home. The bench. Yeah, this is, it's my bench. The museum paid for it because I was the curator there. Yeah, and they did that to remember me because, I am dead. It's been some adjustment, but not all bad. I should probably go and check on the museum, actually. Yeah, I've been collecting the stories of Shelmerston for years now, here in my museum. There are so many stories, and wonderful ones. The museum started off small, but just grew and grew. It's shut at the moment, of course. Not sure what's going to happen with it now that I'm no longer doing it. I do like coming back here, though. Gives me a bit of purpose, which I've really missed since, becoming dead. Oh, one thing that's been keeping me amused. Since I've been dead, I've found I can do some new things. I'm not sure what use it is, but it's been keeping me quite entertained. Ah, but the novelty's worn off. I mean, it's been, well, I don't know how long exactly, but an awful long time since I've had anyone to talk to. Well, anyone who talked back, anyway. No, I couldn't. That sounds like... Sparky. Is that you?
Morris. Come with me. I need to show you something.
It's Sparky?
Morris, you worked it out.
You can talk?
Well, I could always talk. You just couldn't understand me.
And you can hear me?
Well, sure. You are talking, aren't you?
Oh, Sparky!
What is it, Morris?
It's been so long. I thought I'd had my last conversation. Oh, I'm so very glad.
I'm glad too, Morris. I've been waiting for you. We need to go...
Wait. Are you really my Sparky? My Sparky girl?
Mostly. The best bits. But listen, I don't know how long before the volcano erupts, but it's not long now.
The volcano? Erupting? But it's dormant.
No. It has been dormant because of the custodian. But the custodian is weakening and we don't know how much longer they can hold on.
The custodian? What are you talking about?
Shelmerston is volcanic. It's supposed to erupt every once in a while. The only reason it hasn't is the custodian, keeping the island calm.
Custodian? Keeping the island calm?
Take your time, Morris. Dogs are better at understanding this kind of stuff than humans.
The custodian is a ghost.
Yes, now you're getting it. The custodian is a ghost who appeases the island, keeps it safe to live on. But the current custodian has been doing the job a long time and really needs to retire.
Oh, and the island needs a new custodian.
That's right. It's up to us to find a new one. There are 5 prospects that I know of. 5 ghosts still hanging around the island who haven't gone into the west yet. We need to find them and see if they'll take the job.
Well, what if none of the prospects wants it?
If the current custodian fades away and there's nobody to commune with the island spirit, well, that would be bad.
Bad how, Sparky?
Volcano bad. You've seen how it's smoking. We don't have long now.
Well, could I be the custodian?
Oh, I wish. But Ghost Code 342B dictates that the custodian must be a ghost who has been dead on this island for at least 1,000 days. We don't have that long.
Ghost Code 342B. Yeah, well, I suppose that makes as much sense as anything else.
Right, let's get going, Morris. Our first prospect is Peter Noach.
Oh, yeah, from the yoga center. Yeah, he died a few years ago, didn't he? Yeah, I remember his funeral on the lighthouse.
Yes, that's the fella. He always had those funny green treats. Let's go pay him a visit.
Well, oh, flying. Oh, this feels nice.
What? Right. Oh, you kind of forget about it after a while.
Well, you always was impressed with this yoga center. It seemed like a chap who went through some tough times. Creating this place really seemed to help him.
Yep, and it's still going strong.
Yoga center run.
Well.
Yeah.
Right.
And...
By looking in...
I spoke. So people then met.
Thank you.
I just got divorced and really wanted to go on a golfing holiday, but my best mate Tammy somehow talked me into doing a yoga retreat instead. Pete was hard to read, you know? Strong, silent type. But you could tell he loved his collection of Buddhas. He said they were like fat little soldiers that kept him safe. To be honest, I thought that was a bit odd. But he was a great teacher. Pete was hard to read, you know? Strong, silent. Pete was very protective about his collection. Hated people messing with them, even telling off Em when she was dusting them.
When Pete arrived at the lighthouse, he needed help running it, but refused all offers. Eventually, fearing the possibility of a shipwreck, Trinity House sent me to Shelmerston to help keep things running smoothly.
I met Pete for the first time on a yoga retreat in Goa. He was the best yoga teacher, but very reserved. I noticed he had some army tattoos. I wanted to ask about them, but he would never talk about himself.
I was getting ready to lay my egg. I was getting ready to lay my egg. But my nest needed that little something extra.